Jesus gets us. I don't think there's anything that I can tell you more important than the fact that Jesus knows everything about us, Jesus adores us, and Jesus constantly invites us to a better, healthier place than where we currently are. In John chapter 3, there's these three verses, check this out. Because of the miraculous signs that Jesus did in Jerusalem at the Passover celebration where Jesus turned the water into wine, because of all that, many began to trust him. Well, imagine that. Jesus shows up at a party that was about to come to a screeching halt, and Jesus made sure by changing water into wine that that party didn't stop for quite some time, and everybody started to trust in him. Hey, this guy does some cool, cool stuff. Verse 24, but Jesus didn't trust them because he knew all about people. Verse 25, no one needed to tell Jesus about human nature, for he knew and knows what is in each person's heart. Jesus knows that we love him when he blesses us, and that we then question him when he doesn't bless us, or maybe at times turn our backs on him when he doesn't bless us, or when he goes silent, or when he allows things to go ways that they shouldn't, that we feel like are unfair or unjust. The reality is Jesus, it says Jesus didn't trust any of them because he knew that we all are fair weather. Now, when I read those scriptures, I got to admit to you, right away I think of people's names. I'm like, yeah, that describes them. Yeah, that describes them. Yeah, that describes them. No, that describes me. That describes me. I am so fair weather. But Jesus is constantly inviting me and you to trust him beyond our circumstances, to be like him and sleep through storms, to be like him and trust in scarcity when we're amidst thousands of people and everybody is hungry, but hey, there's loaves, fishes, and Jesus present. Jesus is good in the midst of all circumstances. He knows us. He gets us. He adores us. And he invites us to a deeper place of trust in him. Where are you in your walk with him? Because these scriptures about Jesus are placed right between the miraculous miracle in Cana and his conversation with Nicodemus, who Nicodemus is trying to figure out, how can I be born again? What in the world? Taking everything literally. And Jesus graciously invites Nicodemus to a place of deeper truth and deeper trust. And he'll graciously invite you and me to do the same. He knows us, he gets us, he adores us, and he invites us to a deeper place of trust. Let's accept his invitation today.